Hello, good morning. I just got back from a morning trip to Costco. Now that I have to go alone and I can't bring any kids for the time being, I just went during Lydia's morning nap. So I am back. It was not quite the fun experience that it used to be, where I'd bring my kids and we'd have samples and, you know, all that kind of fun. It's a little bit more, it's just a different experience. Whoops, hold on, phone call. Okay, I'm back. So we have a family of 10 people here, and I really like doing once a month grocery shopping. I feel like it helps me to be better organized. It forces me to really plan ahead. I save money because there's less impulse buying. However, I'm with the limits and the way things are right now, it's just working best to do every 2 weeks is what I'm That's what I think anyway. That's what I think I'm going to do. I'm also hoping to place an order with Azure Standard. I missed the cutoff for this month of April. So let's see. We're coming to the very end of April. There's just a couple days left, 1 week left, I guess. And I am going to try to do that for the month of May. So mid-May, I will be placing an order with them. So enough talking. Let me show you what I bought today. My total was $296.47. We've got some chips that we will ration out for some fun here and there this 2 week period. We have a Samuel and a Jeremiah. They were a special deal at Costco today. Okay, so these, I bought these last month and I got them again this time instead of the oats that we had been buying in the past. These are sprouted rolled oats, so they're a little bit easier on the digestive system. So I got 2 bags of those. The flour is still a limit of 1. So I just got 1 bag of gluten-free flour, and they did not have any organic flour for my sourdough bread, any organic wheat flour, but I still have the some of the spelt flour left that my father-in-law had picked up and brought for me last time. So that will hold us over for now. Now we are planning to do some juicing here. We're just, juicing is the way that we stay healthy and fight off all of the things that are going around. And so carrots were a great price. They were under $5 for this big 6 pound bag. It was 4 something. So I went ahead and bought 5 bags of carrots. We're going to do a lot of carrot juice. We also are going to be getting a case of apples this week. That's not on this thing here. So just that we're going to be given another case of apples. We've been getting about 1 a week of apples and often 1 of oranges. So that's a great blessing. So apple carrot juice is my favorite. So that will be wonderful. I got some power greens to add to our smoothies. We like to do smoothies with yogurt or fresh milk that we get delivered, and then I throw in some frozen fruit. So the power greens will go in there. This avocado oil is what I've been using, and we really like that. It's a little more expensive. It's $18.99 for that big container, but it lasts us at least a month, and it's a better quality oil for us. So that's what we're doing. Okay, this is just a little bag of snack cucumbers. I saw them and grabbed them on the way out. I thought they'd make a fun snack today. 1 bag of avocados. I'm wanting to try those with Lydia, actually, to see how she likes them. But we have lots of avocado fans here. They seem like they're really expensive right now. It was $8.99 for that little bag of avocados. You know, if price wasn't an issue, I would get tons of avocados, but at least we got 1 bag. Okay, a big bag of these celery sticks. These are $5.99 for that bag, and it's a 2.5 pound bag. I forgot the bananas over here. I still have lots of bananas from when we got a bunch and put them in the freezer, but it's nice to have a couple fresh. So I just got 1 bunch of those. Chocolate chips, of course. How can we quarantine without chocolate chips, right? Okay, 2 containers of honey. I've been going through a lot more honey since I've been baking this sourdough bread, because for most of the recipes, honey is used. So we've got 2 of those. 3 of these big tubs of organic yogurt. I like getting the yogurt when I go to this specific Costco. There are 2 Costcos in our area, and they actually vary a little bit in the items that they carry. This particular one has this big tub of organic yogurt, and it is $6.99, and it's a big, let's see, 64-ounce tub. So I went ahead and got 3 of those. When we get plenty of milk, we actually get milk delivered from a local farmer. In addition to this grocery haul, we get
milk delivered weekly. Right now she's been a little bit low, and so we only got, I think, 3 gallons or 3.5 last week. So that's barely enough to drink. Like, it's not enough to drink. Who am I kidding? 6.5 is usually about perfect, but we got 3 or 3.5. So that did not leave me any wiggle room to make yogurt. We just pretty much consumed it. So I went ahead and bought some yogurt this time. Okay, we got 2 of these 100% grass-fed beef patties. There's 15 giant beef patties in there, and I've started buying this grass-fed one because it's only a little bit more than the conventional package of beef patties that they have there. And let's see, how much did that come to? Because I'm all curious now. It was $19.49 for that. And like I said, there's 15 of those in there. Okay, sorry, I'm doing this one-handed with a baby, so that makes it a little tricky. Okay, we got some more green beans and corn. I still have some mixed vegetables and broccoli left in the freezer. And then more of the frozen fruit, which we really like in smoothies and also in yogurt. I have 1 of these left in my freezer, so we have 2 bags of each for this 2 weeks. We have a few of these 2-pound packages of cheese. I was completely out of cheese, and also a sour cream. They did not have the normal rice that I had bought in the past. They had this one, which I have never seen before. But I went ahead and, you know, beggars can't be choosers these days. It seems like the big bulk items are running out, or they're having shortages or limit ones. This was a limit one, so I just went ahead and got that because it's better to have it than not. So we'll give it a try and let you know what we think about that. That is all I have for this month. Like I said, we have fresh milk delivered. We get eggs from our chickens, about a dozen a day, and I still have some beef and venison left in the freezer, and I also have chickens in the freezer. And by the time those run out, my daughter is actually incubating eggs to try raising our own meat chickens. So if this all goes as planned, I may not be needing to buy chicken anymore, which would be pretty great. You ready for a nap? That's all I have for today. I will keep you posted as we go throughout the month and buy more. So thanks so much, and we will see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.